in the election campaign was saying that in his 5-point plan for Europe, his number one priority was completing the digital single market, and in this area having a copyright reform. Because one of the big problems that we have is that unlike the United States, for example, that has one copyright for 50 states, we have 28 copyrights for every single member state. And so far, the European Union has only harmonized certain privileges or rights of the rights holders. So the question of which actions are protected by copyright, and this is mostly implementing the international treaties that the European Union is signatory to, but it has done very little in the sense of creating universal users' rights or defining what is a privilege of the public and which actions are allowed. So every single member state has their own rules for whether there are copyright exceptions for things like education, for parody, for citation. And this, of course, in the internet age is making the exchange of culture across borders within the European Union extremely difficult. The territoriality of copyright basically means that you can have one work that is in the public domain in one country but protected by copyright in another country. Just to give you one example, in every European country, Le Petit Prince, the novel by Saint-Exupéry, is in the public domain, except for France, because he died in 1944, and France has a national copyright law that is saying that the copyright term is longer if the artist died for France in the Second World War. So this basically means that if I create a work based on Le Petit Prince in Germany, and a friend of mine is sharing this in France over the internet, they may be committing a copyright infringement. And this, of course, basically means that the person who is sharing works within the European Union has to be a legal expert in deviation from copyright laws in order to understand what is allowed and what is not allowed. And this has basically led to the chilling effects that we've also heard in the keynote, that most people don't know what is allowed and what is not allowed. And there are two strategies to this. Either you ignore copyright completely and you call yourself a pirate and download and share anything the way you like, or you rather not do anything, and particularly people who are creating tend to take the second route, because they really have this feeling, okay, I might end up making money with this, so I really need to know whether what I'm doing is legal or not, and then the cost of actually finding this out is too high. So this is kind of the problem that we're facing, and the European Commission has identified this, and also the new commissioners who are responsible for this topic, the Vice President Andrus Ansip from Estonia and the German Günther Oettinger, they are both frustrated that they cannot watch football in Brussels from their own countries because there are artificial borders on the internet between the European states. So we know that a reform is going to come, but of course these announcements and the identification of the problem is already making a lot of people uneasy. So in the fall, the European Parliament appointed me as rapporteur to review the main piece of legislation in the existing EU copyright law, which is the 2001 Copyright Directive, which was basically transposing some of the international treaties from the 1990s about copyright and the internet into EU law. And the main finding of my report is that having 28 different copyright systems within a single market simply doesn't work. It doesn't work for the rights holders or the artists who basically have an artificially limited